Good morning, everybody. Time for a wolfofbricks.com update. Once again, I am Jim, and this is where we talk about Lego investing and reselling. So here we go. Wanted to introduce the website to you, and I also wanted to go ahead and show a feature to the website. You may have known what it was if you checked out the thumbnail. Very excited about this website. Now, you may be saying to yourself, Jim, it took you 2 months to do this website? Well, yeah, actually. There were a lot of things going on behind the scenes that we decided not to include in this website at the moment. We will be including a few other things in a few weeks. And we're also going to be showcasing something at the beginning of the year that I'm very excited about. So stay tuned for that. So just wanted to go over it with you real quick. There's only a few tabs, and I would like everybody to stick around at the end of the video because I will be doing a giveaway to celebrate the launch of this website. So first up is the homepage, right? You know, we just have a couple articles now. Every week we're going to be having a couple more articles. We have the articles tab, which is going to be an archive of all the articles. We're only going to showcase a couple articles at the front homepage. The YouTube tab, of course, takes you to my YouTube channel if that's something that you cared to see. There's also an About Me section that we don't have to worry about because you should already know who I am. And we also have the merch section. So let's talk about that real quick. So for all of you folks that have been saying, and there's been a lot that have been saying, hey, when are you going to go ahead and add t-shirts? Or when can I go ahead and buy some Brick Club t-shirts? Well, guess what? Now's your chance. So all you need to do, if you've never been on the internet before, is you just need to click on whatever shirt you want, and then it'll go ahead and it'll take you to the Etsy store. You can see this nice lady. She's a brick mom. After she's done playing with Legos with her daughter, she's gonna get on her motorcycle and go somewhere. You also have this guy right here. After he's done playing with his children, he's gonna start going to the gym and flexing that he's a brick dad to everybody that sees him. So lots of exciting things going on in the merch tab. But most importantly, we're going to talk about the retirement lists that I have. I have retirement lists from 2021 all the way to 2026. Now, as we get further along, the lists will start to shrink a little bit. Well, Jim, why is that? Well, the information that I compiled came from brickset.com, and I was able to go ahead and scrape all that information and post it on my website so everybody could go ahead and check it out. Now, if you recall, I have done audit videos of retirement lists in the past on another YouTube channel. And when we're talking about the Stone Wars list, I think that's somewhere around 86% accurate, right? Well, here's the thing. You know, the interesting thing was whenever I grabbed all the information that I could from Brickset in regards to retirement lists, it's very interesting. And the reason why I say that is because it goes up to 2026, but whenever I scroll down all the way on the Excel spreadsheet, I mean, this information is going all the way back to the 90s, which is interesting. And, you know, I'm not exactly sure what that means, but for myself, you know, if Brickset wanted to go ahead and, you know, just throw retirement dates up there, they could, right? But it seems like they've been compiling this data for some time, or, you know, maybe they got this information from Lego going all the way to the 90s, and then they went ahead and they included it on their website just for kicks, I guess. But it's pretty interesting. So when we talk about accuracy of retirement lists, right, one of the sites you could go to is Lego Shop at Home. After all, they're the ones that sell the product, right? But if you go to the retiring soon, you can see that there's only 17 results, right? And if you're that person that wants to grab as many Minecraft sets as you can get, or Harry Potter sets that are hopefully retiring, you really need something more, right? You just don't want to be left holding a bag of cash come February and let all that opportunity pass you by. So if you go to Stone Wars, you can see that they list 4 Lego art sets that are retiring. If you go to my website, which I got all the information from Brickset, you can see that there's only 3 art sets retiring. And when you go to Lego Shop at Home, you can see there's only 1 set retiring. So it'll be interesting. You know, I do plan on auditing Brickset just like I audited Stone Wars in the past. And I would say up until now, Stone Wars was probably the most accurate website when it comes to retiring sets and getting information that you need. But in my opinion, Brickset really is the standard when it comes to LEGO websites. Not to take anything away from Stone Wars, but until I'm proven otherwise, I'm pretty much going to go with the Brickset data. And again, I'll go ahead and I will be auditing all of that data come March, April, or May, sometimes like that. So just wanted to go ahead and pass along a feature that I have on my website. And, you know, you could click it anytime at your leisure. And, of course, you know, don't forget the merch if that's something that you wanted to do. All right, now it's time for the giveaway. Well, I do plan on giving away this set right here, set number 10249. Winter Toy Shop, a retired set. And of course, it's very easy to go ahead and participate in this giveaway. All you have to do is like, subscribe, and just go ahead and write down what your favorite set is. It honestly could be anything. It's that easy. All right, that's it, my friends. As always, I'm Jim with wolfofbricks.com. Always go out there and get it.